Small Axe Lover's Rock is the freedom that the Mangrove Nine fought for. It's the story of black youths in Britain in the 1980s finding love and freedom at a house party at a time when they were not permitted into white nightclubs. The Mangrove Nine marched to hold on to a place where they could eat spicy West Indian food and cling on and keep and be a part of that community that they grew up with and were used to back home in the Caribbean, and they wanted to hold on to that place and have peace and thrive there. And I don't know about you, but Lover's Rock really kind of felt like the victory that Mangrove Nine were fighting for. And it carried a real heavy sense of nostalgia, which at first was kind of weird to me, and this is really for two reasons. Reason number one is that obviously, I was not alive in the 1980s, and you know, I never had to face being rejected from clubs on a basis of race, and therefore didn't have to turn to single community house parties. Reason number two, though one side of my heritage is exactly the same as the characters in this film, I'd never experienced black culture in this way. I've been in and around it since I was a kid, but it's kind of only really when I was a kid, and you know, the party that's depicted here in Lover's Rock is not the kind of place where a kid's gonna be found. And yet, everything when watching Lover's Rock felt completely familiar to me. It was kind of as if, like, that is exactly what I did with my Friday and Saturday nights pre-COVID. Heck, I feel it's exactly what I want to do with my nights post-COVID. Not necessarily setting up or going to a blues party, though fuck yeah, I'm in if anyone's got one going, but certainly to once again capture and hold on tightly to that freedom, that love, that unity that comes along with it. To be around people and express myself through dance, through song, through togetherness. Now look, that nostalgic feeling I picked up when watching Lover's Rock may not be exactly the same as the older generations who were actually living those parties, but it was installed into me nonetheless. And I really have to applaud Steve McQueen and everyone involved for installing that nostalgic feeling into myself and to probably thousands, if not millions, of other people. Like, McQueen takes his audience and places them slap bang in the middle of this party. There is no heavy dialogue. In fact, there's not really much light dialogue either, but you are kind of there for the whole thing. You are there for the setup, you are there for the experiencing, for the enjoyment, for this party. If you are watching this video and you're yet to watch Lover's Rock, when you do, I urge you to plug in your speakers, turn up the volume, pour yourself a drink, and get fucking involved, man. However, Lover's Rock goes a little bit further than just a real good time and just kind of, you know, reliving and recapturing things that have come before. No, what it does is it also, for me, represents black people here in Britain in a way that we're used to seeing ourselves. This is how we see ourselves, just fucking enjoying life. I've probably sworn way too much at this point in the video. It's a good thing I can't get monetized, because then I can't get demonetized. And it's a kind of light that hasn't really been shown to the mainstream, at least not the way I remember watching anything before. You know, I'm used to seeing black people as criminals. I'm used to seeing black people that are in gangs. I'm used to seeing black people as the best friend. I'm used to watching black people suffering through slavery. But there aren't many stories that I know of where black people just get to have a good time, undisturbed, in a place where they feel secure and at peace to express themselves. And I really feel that Small Axe Lover's Rock could and should mark the point at the turning point for black people to be represented for who they actually are and what we're actually all about. I mean, the outpouring on Twitter is testament to this. You know, I'm seeing tweets of so much joy and admiration and love. I've never seen that kind of thing from this part of the community before on Twitter. And actually, it's not just the black community that are finding everything that I've found in it. No, it's people from all kinds of communities are tweeting about this. And for me, that's really what the film is about. It's finding that space where we can all come together and love and unify and just be free. And like, I don't know about y'all, but that middle section with the Silly Games rendition, that took me to a whole new plane of existence. I've walked and I've partied in other circles before, but I can tell you none of them came close to what McQueen was able to capture and present to us in Lover's Rock. There it is, like, we're two films into Small Axe already, and I kind of don't know if it can get much better than that. For me, Lover's Rock is a film film, I will be watching over and over and over and over and over again. When I need to find that collective unity, when I need to find a collective of expression, when I need to find collective freedom, Lovers Rock, it's where I'll be, and hopefully I'll see you there too. If you'd like to know my thoughts on Small Axe Mangrove, make sure you click right here. And for many more videos, click right there. And if you want to see future content on the Small Axe Anthology, make sure you subscribe and turn on that bell notification. Until then, Hakuna Matata.